And what we've seen is that it's predominantly human rights organizations, advocacy organizations, environmental organizations. Various initiatives that are speaking out are being simply put on the register of foreign agents by the state. And since they are on that register, things are getting very difficult to them.
Ms. Anna Sevortian is a human rights defender who leads the EU-Russia Civil Society Forum, a diverse network of non-governmental organizations from Russia and the European Union. Each member shares the belief that a strong and vocal civil society plays a key role in democracy, sustainable development, and peace. Sevortian recently had an opportunity to discuss the plight of Russian civil rights organizations with U.S. Senators Kirsten Gillibrand, Bob Corker, Chris Murphy, and Jean Shaheen. She told the senators about the risks civil rights workers in Russia have taken when promoting peace and human rights. Sevortian told the senators the story of the Russian organization Women of the Dawn, whose efforts have been hampered due to state-imposed legal actions and whose leader is being targeted by the Russian government.
Valentina Cherevasenko, the head of the organization that works in the south of Russia, the Women of the Dawn, it's called, and they are engaged now in peacekeeping. They're trying to bring together citizens from Russia and Ukraine and rebuild the trust, though it's an ongoing war, which is an ongoing huge scar on both of our societies. And Valentina is doing courageous work. And unfortunately, that work is being penalized in Russia.
In 2017, Sherevatenko was charged for non-compliance with the foreign agents law. After many organizations campaigned on her behalf, the case was dropped due to absence of the elements of the crime. The hard work continues to ensure that NGOs and human rights defenders in Russia can work freely without fear of persecution and prosecution. Sevortian says international solidarity is absolutely essential in times of shrinking space for civil society. Sevortian explains that the foreign agents law is a way to stigmatize human rights and peace activists.
Well, what the foreign agents law does, it restricts the freedoms of organizations that are supposedly engaged in the political activities and are getting foreign funding. It's harder to work, you can no longer work with officials, you cannot really work with foreign money, so the burden for your organization is such that many organizations prefer to deregister, but they simply cannot live anymore with that stigma of being a foreign agent. It means foreign spy.
Sevortian says that activists are resilient, but that the environment has been created where organizations are viewed with suspicion and labeled as undesirables. Anna and other human rights leaders in Eastern Europe and Russia are calling for greater support from U.S. and European governments for the dangerous but vital work of promoting human rights and peace throughout the region.
It's very difficult to pursue those ideas of peace, tolerance, justice, human rights. Whenever a conversation is happening with Russia or one of those interlocutors in Eastern Europe or anywhere else, human rights should be part of that conversation.